Greetings, quilters. I'm Stuart Hillard, and welcome to the latest Quilting Classroom brought to you by Create & Craft TV and Accuquilt. Now, if you haven't already signed up for our channel, you should subscribe and then you won't miss a single video, free pattern or tutorial that we bring to you. You can do that by just following the link at the end of the video. Now, in today's Quilting Classroom, we're going to be looking at a very special die from Accuquilt called Local Colour. And it's one of our designer dies designed by quilt designer Bill Kerr. Now, the die that we're going to be looking at today is what we call a block on board or a bob. And a block on board is a really special kind of die because you have everything that you need on that one die to create your whole block or quilt, which is fantastic. Now, another great thing about the Local Colour die is that this die is compatible with all machines. So it doesn't matter whether you've got the Go Baby, the Go, or the Go Big, Local Colour will work. You are going to need the 6x24 cutting mat if you've got a Go Baby. If you've got a Go or a Go Big, you could use your 12x24 cutting mat for the die instead. So let's start by having a quick look at some quilts that we've made using Local Colour. First of all, we've got this fantastic vision in black, white, and red. Now, what you can see in this quilt is that we've got a series of overlapping circles. And as the circles overlap, the colours kind of blend and you get that sort of sense of transparency and overlay. It's a great scrap buster. And if you want to have a go at modern quilting or you are a modern quilter, this is a fantastic quilt block. Now, another idea that we've put together is this fantastic wall runner or table runner on this side, which is also using Local Colour. And this wall hanging is very much about the seasons. So we start with spring at the top and then move into summer. Then we get into autumn or fall. And then finally at the bottom, winter. So just four blocks together in a runner, and you've got this fantastic seasonal runner, which I think is really fun and modern and just a little bit different. Now, it's a little bit of curved piecing, but I'm going to show you in today's tutorial how to do curved piecing the easy way. And with Accuquilt, it makes everything so accurate, so easy. We've got those Buenos notches that make it so easy to put your patches together. And it's going to make you rethink curved piecing, I promise. Now, let's have a quick look at the die before we get started. You can see on the front of the die this whole idea of transparency. Now, Bill has actually designed a beautiful quilt. If you go to the Accuquilt website, you can download Bill Kerr's Local Colour quilt pattern. And that is all about transparency. So as blue and green are overlaid, we get blue-green. As yellow and red are overlaid, we get orange. And this is just about sort of digging into your stash, looking at your stash of scraps and fabrics and picking those fabrics that create that transparency effect. And Bill's used a consistent grey throughout. So this is another great idea and a free pattern brought to you from Accuquilt. So I'm going to grab the die out ready. And you can see there that it cuts three different shapes. And on each of them, we've got some notches. Now our die is going to cut these notches out and we're going to use those to help us to piece our Local Colour block together. The Local Colour block, when you put it together, when you put two units together, it finishes as a 12-inch block. I've got one of these set out right here, which I'm going to show you right now. And this block that I've made uses a solid grey for the background. I've used a sort of sky blue, kingfisher blue, for the overlap in the circle. And then what I'm creating are a series of overlapping circles to make a runner. So this finished block as it is 12 inches square when finished. So this would mix and match really well with things like your 6-inch or your 12-inch cubes as well. So you could create some really fantastic effects using this block in conjunction with your cube or maybe your strip dies. So let's get started then, and let's cut out our pieces. So I've got my go cutter at the ready, and I'm just going to move that into position. I'm actually using the 12 by 24 cutting mat, which is absolutely fine. And I've got my fabrics at the ready. Now, little tip here. Just because your block on board has all the pieces for one whole block, it doesn't mean that you necessarily want to cut all of your fabrics in one cut. You can if you're going to mix and match all of your different colours up, your background, your circles, your overlaps as well. You could just put up to 6 layers over the top of the whole die. But if you're going to use, you know, the same colour for different parts of the block, what you don't want is for 6 layers of, say, the grey fabric here, 6 layers of this fabric, and there being an area where they overlap, because suddenly we're introducing 12 layers, potentially, into our machine, and our machine's not going to be happy trying to cut that. So you're much better off cutting each section separately, but do up to 6 layers of each. So I'm going to start by cutting my ellipse, that bit in the center where my shapes overlap. So I've got my kingfisher blue. Now I'm really having to lean back out of the way here because this is a long die. You might want to do this standing up, but... And this takes the longest of any die to go through because of the length. But there we go. That's my center ellipse cut out. Brilliant, perfect. So we've got those cut. So I'll put those to one side. I'm going to cut enough for 2 blocks. I've got a couple of different fabrics for my overlapping circles. So I'm going to lay those over that part of the die. And actually, because there's no chance of any kind of overlap, I'm going to put my other pieces down the bottom at the same time so I can cut these in one go. And then lay my mat on top. And then let's feed this through. So there we go, all my pieces cut. Now, my favourite thing to do once I've cut out all of my pieces is always to lay my pieces out on the table to make sure that I've cut the right pieces, that I'm happy with my fabric choices, for example, and also that, you know, everything is going to go together nicely. So let's just grab these pieces out. And I've also got my grey fabrics down here. Okay. Right, so I can get rid of my die now. Pop that out the way. And also get rid of my machine. And then lay out my pieces. Okay. So remember, this was my original block. And what I want is for the next block to carry on from here. So I'm going to need that fabric next, then my overlap, then my next fabric will go here, and then I've got my grey fabric for the top and the bottom. And then I've also got pieces cut ready for my next unit. But you can see how that is going to go together. So this is my next unit. So this actual unit here is going to be 6 inches wide, 12 inches deep. So that's a sort of half block, but you could certainly regard that as a full block, and you could also create some fantastic quilts and effects using that. Right, let's get to the piecing. Let me show you how easy it is to do this curved piecing. Now, the first thing that we're going to piece together is this section of the overlapping circle with the top grey, top and bottom. So we're going to stitch this seam here and this seam here. So I'm going to grab my pins. Now, quite often when I'm sewing, I don't use pins, or I don't use many pins. When I'm doing curved piecing, I will crack the pins out. Now, the first thing to do is to match up the notches. And you can see there where I'm just bringing my notches together. And once they're perfectly matched up, grab a pin and push a pin through that notch to keep it held together. These are so useful, having these notches. Now, the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to bring the start of both patches together and pin there. And then you're just going to make sure that those pieces of fabric in between are beautifully lined up. Now, if I'm not in the mood for pinning, I don't pin. If I am in the mood for pinning, I really pin. So don't be alarmed at the number of pins I'm putting in here, and don't feel that you have to put the same number of pins in. I just, you know, I dislike pinning less than I dislike unpicking. So I work on the principle that if I spend a couple of extra minutes pinning everything really carefully, I probably won't have to ever unpick anything. Could be famous last words, but I hope not. So I'm just going to pin those sections together. Okay, and we're ready to start sewing. Now, I'm going to sew with that grey section, that background section on top. That's the piece that feels fuller. There's more sort of gathers. Can you see we've kind of got almost like the pleats on a dress? They're nowhere near the actual seam. And that's important because we don't want to sew tucks into our work. But this side that looks more gathered, as a general rule of thumb, you always want that section to be on top when you're sewing. All right, so we're going to go under our sewing machine. Now, I'm using red thread throughout for my piecing because I want it to be nice and clear for you at home. But at home, you might want to use something like a mid-toned neutral grey or buff colour. Now, another little tip, when you're sewing curved seams, I like to reduce my stitch length just a little. So my default setting is 2.2, so I just knock that down to a 2. And just having that shorter, slightly shorter stitch length just helps me to get a smoother curve when I'm sewing. It is a little bit harder if you have to unpick. There are more stitches to unpick. But if we've pinned right and we sew right, we shouldn't need to unpick. Okay, so I've done that curved seam. I can clip my threads, get into good habits. And then I'm going to take all of those pins out and show you that seam that I've sewn. Okay, so that seam is sewn now. And what I'm going to do is just open that up, and then I'm going to open my seam. Normally we press our seams one way or the other, but on this particular pattern we recommend that you press your seams open. And the easiest thing to do is to first of all open them with your fingernail and just run your fingernail along them until they flatten out. Once you've got them nice and flat, you can just go to your ironing board and then gently press. Okay, and it should definitely be a pressing motion rather than a sort of vigorous rubbing back and forth. Okay, so that seam is now sewn. I didn't even break into a sweat. You know, that's how easy curve piecing can be. Doesn't have to be stressful or hard. It's not stressful or hard if your pieces are cut out accurately. Now we're going to do exactly the same down the other end of the block. So once again, I am matching up the notches and pinning there first, and then pinning at either end. If you match those three patches, and actually, you know what? That is great advice when you're doing patchwork generally. Match up the ends first and pin them. Match up the middle and pin there. And then pin in between. And if you do that with all of your patching, you won't go far wrong. So I'm just going to add a couple more pins in between those sections just to make sure that everything is held together nice and securely. I'll probably get away with one pin, but I'm putting in two just because I'm being good today. So let's go back to sewing. So again, I've got that short stitch length, just slightly shorter, and press the foot down. Now, when you're sewing a curved seam, you've got that fuller side on top. Just make sure as you go that you're not stitching any pleats or tucks. So just from time to time, rearrange your fabric, smooth it out if you need to, just to make sure that everything stays nice and flat and smooth. Trim off your threads, pins out, and then just as you did before, you're going to press that seam open with your fingers first of all. Just give it a little, I like to work from the center out, almost like a little sort of scratching motion, just to push those seam allowances open, and then pop to your ironing mat and press that seam open. And we've pieced the first section, that top and bottom. Now you can see quite clearly that that leaves this wonderful curve here for this section to go into. So this is the section that we're going to piece next. Super easy. We've got our notches to help us. So again, we're going to match up that middle notch and pin. Match up either end and pin. And then pin in between. It's as simple as that. Now, I haven't clipped any of my seams at the moment, but there are one or two seams in this block where just a little bit of clipping wouldn't hurt. If you're a dressmaker, you'll be used to clipping into curved seams around things like armholes and, you know, sleeve openings, that kind of thing, or when you set in sleeves. In patchwork, we tend to do it less, but on a curved seam, it can help just to make everything lie nice and flat. And you'll know if you need to clip into a seam because it will feel taut when you're pressing it. And if it feels taut and it's kind of curling as you're trying to press it, it's an indication that maybe just a little bit of clipping would help. Okay, so again, I've got that fuller side on top, yeah? The bit that's like kind of a pleated skirt. Have that on top when you're sewing. So back under the machine, quarter inch seam again. Now, most of us who are patchworkers are very used to sewing quarter inch seams when they are straight. Keeping a quarter inch seam when you're sewing round a curve just reminds us that we need to be looking not at the needle, but at the edge of the foot. And we're looking at the right hand side of our foot and making sure that that stays lined up with the raw edges of our fabric. If we do that, then we'll maintain a really even quarter inch seam. If you're one of those sewers that tends to stare at the needle bobbing up and down, and there are lots of us that do that, this will really highlight that and just remind you that you should be looking at the raw edge of your fabric. And once you start doing that, you'll suddenly find that your quarter inch seam allowance is a lot more accurate. So again, pins out, open that seam. Now this is one of those seams where you could clip into it. If you are going to clip into it, do it now, and you're just snipping to within maybe three threads or four threads of your seam allowance. Don't clip right down to your seam line that you have sewn, because there's a danger that you'll really weaken the seam. Okay, that's enough. So we're just doing a few clips, probably every quarter of an inch or so, and this will just help your seam allowance to lie flatter when you press it open. It does make it slightly harder to open up because rather than being one long seam now, it's in several sections because we've clipped. But there we go, that wasn't difficult at all. And again, a pressing motion just to flatten that seam down, and a little go from the front. Oh, smashing. And there we go. We've got that lovely, smooth sewn curve. And this piece now is just ready to fit in right there. Now you'll notice that we've got a notch here and we've got a corresponding notch here. We've got a notch in the center and we've got a notch here to match. And then we've also got a notch here and one more here to match up. We've got two other places that we need to make sure match up, and that is our seam intersections. So we've got five different places here, plus the start and finish to match up. Now, match points actually make our job a whole lot easier. The hardest patches to try and sew together is where there is no clear middle or midpoint or quarter point, or even a start or finish. Having these matching points makes our job of matching really, really easy. So I'm pinning all of those match points first. So that means seven pins, one for each of the match points plus the start and finish. And then I might just put one more pin in between. Okay. So a couple more over this side. Now remember that this is a 12-inch block and it takes around about 20-25 minutes to cut and piece that block. So even though you're having to do pinning, which maybe you don't ordinarily do, you are still getting an awful lot of block for your time. The impact of this block is very much about those overlapping circles and that accuracy. So this is where it's worth spending that little bit of time. So a couple more pins in between, just to make sure everything lines up. As always, on your pattern or on your die itself, there are instructions on how to use your die, how to cut on the lengthwise grain, for example. But also there are some great quilt pattern ideas. So don't throw the packaging away, keep it and use it, and also experiment with it and try out different ideas, different colours. Okay, so I've got that all pinned and I'm going to do my last bit of sewing, which again I'm going from that side which feels more kind of fuller, feels more gathered. And as I sew, I'm just making sure that I'm not sewing any tucks or pleats into this seam. I'm keeping it lying really nice and flat. Still using that slightly shorter stitch length. And this is the fullest part of the block, so I'm just taking a moment just to make sure that everything is nice and smooth and there are no tucks or pleats as I'm sewing. Just slowing down slightly where I need to. And keep going, we are almost there. Home run now, we're onto the grey. And again, if you need to, this is the seam that you could clip into just to make it lie really nice and flat. Okay, there we go. So pins out. It takes almost as much time to take the pins out as it does to put them in. But they've done their job. There we go. And then I'm gonna just finger press that seam open. Again, you could clip this if you want to, but I'm not sure it's always necessary. So let's just push that seam open carefully. I like to finger press all of my seams, whether it's curved patchwork or straight line sewing. I always like to finger press my seams. Normally we would do our seams to one direction or the other, usually to the darker side. But you know, in this situation, pressing your seams open will give you a much better finish. So let's just press that seam open nicely. And keep coming around the other side. Try not to flip your previous seam allowances with your iron as you're doing this. Keep everything nice and flat. And then we'll flip it over and do a final press from the front. Now, don't worry about any slight creases. Fabric does tend to crease up as you're sewing curved seams, simply because you're putting these kind of curves together. So there we go. We've got our next unit pieced and ready to join on. This is the easiest bit. All you've got to do is match up where your circles join together. So pin either side. I reckon one pin in the middle. And I can hold the top and the bottom together. So let's sew this last seam together. So we're saying sewing straight down that seam. Now, because we've pressed all our other seam allowances open, I'm gonna still press this final seam allowance open as well. So we'll clip our threads. There we go, pins out. Get the ironing surface ready. And then just working from the back to begin with, open up that seam, and from the center out, push that seam allowance open. And then same again, working from the center out, just push that seam allowance open. And then flip it over to the front and give it a final press. And we are done. There is our local colour, our overlapping circles, a fantastic modern block on board quilt pattern brought to you from Bill Kerr in conjunction with Accuquilt. Now I think this is a really fantastic quilt block to expand your skills, to try curved piecing if you never have before. Hopefully I've shown you that it's easy and successful when you use your AccuQuilt dies. And you know, it really is a fun sense of achievement. So that's your local colour brought to you from AccuQuilt and Bill Kerr. Don't forget, if you aren't already a subscriber, make sure to click the subscribe button so that you don't miss any videos, tutorials or free patterns from AccuQuilt and me, Stuart Hillard. Thanks for watching, and remember, better cuts make better quilts. I'll see you all next time. Take care.